Friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Tanish here. In this video, I am going to give you an introduction to quantum computing. Let's start. Quantum computing began in the early 1980s when physicist Paul Benioff proposed a quantum mechanical model of the Turing machine. Richard Feynman and Yuri Manin later suggested that a quantum computer had the potential to simulate things that a classical computer could not. In 1994, Peter Shor developed a quantum algorithm for factoring integers that had the potential to decrypt RSA-encrypted communications. Next, we will discuss what is quantum computing. Quantum computing is the use of quantum mechanical phenomenon such as superposition and entanglement to perform computation. Computers that perform quantum computations are known as quantum computers. Next thing we need to understand is qubit. The basis of quantum computing is the qubit. Unlike a normal computer bit, which can be 0 or 1, a qubit can be either of those, or a superposition of both 0 and 1. Superposition and entanglement are two features of quantum physics on which of these supercomputers are based. This empowers quantum computers to handle operations at speeds exponentially higher than conventional computers and at much lesser energy consumption. Next, we will discuss in detail about superposition. Superposition refers to the quantum phenomenon where a quantum system can exist in multiple states or places at the exact same time. In other words, something can be here, there, or up and down at the same time. Quantum superposition is a fundamental principle of quantum mechanics. It states that, much like waves in classical physics, any two quantum states can be added together and the result will be another valid quantum state, and conversely, that every quantum state can be represented as a sum of two or more other distinct states. Schrodinger's cat is a thought experiment sometimes described as a paradox, devised by Austrian physicist Erwin Schrodinger in 1935 during the course of discussion with Albert Einstein. In Schrodinger's imaginary experiment, you place a cat in a box with a tiny bit of radioactive substance. When the radioactive substance decays, it triggers Geiger counter, which causes a poison or explosion to be released that kills the cat. The cat ends up both dead and alive at the same time. Because the existence of a cat that is both dead and alive at the same time is absurd and does not happen in the real world, this thought experiment shows that wave function collapses are not just driven by conscious observers. Next phenomenon we need to understand is quantum entanglement. Quantum entanglement is the name given to a special connection between pairs or groups of quantum systems or any objects described by quantum mechanics. Quantum entanglement is one of the biggest parts of quantum mechanics that makes it hard to understand in terms of everyday world. Particles of light or photons can be entangled by splitting single particle into two photons in a laser arrangement with a special crystal. Researchers can generate pairs of qubits that are entangled, which means the two members of a pair exist in a single quantum state, Changing the state of one of the qubits will instantaneously change the state of the other one in a predictable way. See, next we will discuss where quantum computers are used. Quantum computers are used in optimization problems, chemistry, artificial intelligence, data security. In a complex data set, in the case of optimization problems, in a complex data set, feature selection involves an exhaustive search whose complexity often reaches exponentially, making it impractical to undertake any such effort. The users end up using heuristic methods with polynomial time complexity. However, quantum computers can accomplish such optimization with polynomial time complexity using parallel computation and without having a need for imperfect heuristic optimization methods. Even optimization is needed in speech recognition, image recognition. Here also we can use quantum computers. And in biology, finding the equilibrium configuration of proteins, we need to use optimization. And, you know, solving satisfiability. Quantum computing and in machine learning, we compute the cost function by summing over the square of the difference of the observed and the expected values for the entire set to arrive at a cost or loss values for each training data set ran against the model. And in machine learning, we compute the cost function by summing over the square of the difference of the observed and the expected values for the entire set to arrive at a cost or loss values for each training data set ran against the model. For non-convex functions, quantum computers are the solution for optimization problems. Quantum computing we use in chemistry as well. By manipulating quantum states of matter and taking advantage of their unique features such as superposition and entanglement, quantum computers promise to efficiently deliver accurate results for many important problems in quantum chemistry, such as the electronic structure of molecules. Next is quantum artificial intelligence. Quantum artificial intelligence is an interdisciplinary field that focuses on building quantum algorithms for improving computational tasks within artificial intelligence, including subfields like machine learning. The entire concept of quantum enhanced AI algorithms is still in conceptual research domain. Once a stable quantum computer gets evolved, expect that machine learning will exponentially accelerate, even reducing the time to solve a problem from hundreds of thousands of years to seconds. Data security. This is another important area where quantum computing can be used. Virtually unbreakable encryptions. Quantum computers will change the landscape of data security. Even though quantum computers would be able to crack many of today's encryption techniques, predictions are that they would create hack-proof replacements. Next is what we are going to discuss is quantum computers a replacement for classical computers? Classical computers are better at some tasks than quantum computers. For example, email, spreadsheets, and desktop publishing, to name a few. The intent of quantum computers is to be a different tool to solve different problems, not to replace classical computers. Google announced it has a quantum computer that is 100 million times faster than any classical computer in its lab. As you try out possible outcomes, the complexity grows exponentially. One thing that we do know about the nature of quantum computing is that algorithms that normally have exponentially evolving complexity only have linear growth in complexity when you view it in the eyes of a quantum computer. Quantum supremacy. In October 2019, Google announced that its quantum computer had done a computation in just 200 seconds, which it claimed that the world's fastest traditional supercomputer would have needed 10,000 years to solve. This means that it had reached a milestone called quantum supremacy, even though a few days later, its rival IBM proved that it could have been done in hours within a modern supercomputer, which would make the quantum computer only 1,000 times faster. In either case, we now know that quantum computing actually works, and it is blistering fast. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thanks a lot.